Thanks for coming. I'll answer any questions for you.
Open up front row, right, Bill. Urban, Eric Smith's finally healthy. He had some big plays last week. What have you seen from him this year? Describe his development.
Well, number one is health, and then number two is maturity. He's taking care of his body, his life, his academics. So I just see a mature, a typical a young guy that maybe wasn't quite as mature when he first got here, and he's really grown up. Yeah, I'll let you handle. I don't want to speak out of line, so I don't micromanage that spot. But I know they're both, Jordan Fuller and him are both rotating.
I just want to get a quick update on some of the injured guys. Chris Worley, Dante Booker, Matt Burrell. How are those guys doing?
Okay, Chris Worley is questionable. Who's the other one?
Booker, Dante Booker.
And he's got spring foot. Dante Booker, full go.
Matt Burrell.
Questionable. He also has a foot, right? Yeah, he's got a foot. But they're not structural issues, so they should be back soon.
Far left, Mitch. Kirby, you have a 40-point underdog. How much of your week was devoted to solving these problems that you, these fundamental problems that you have with your own team, and how much was game planning?
Oh, very good question. I think it's coordinated. I mean, that's a big part of our getting ready for this game is the continual growth of pass defense, of execution of our pass game, of playing with rhythm and tempo on offense. Those are all areas that's part of our game plan. So to answer your question, it's a mix of both. Getting ready to play. They're primarily a four-down defense. We haven't seen that in a couple weeks. And getting ready for that because it's a new defense, and then also just working our weaknesses. And so to answer your question, both.
Yeah, Coach, what's the challenge? Obviously, JT and Dwayne have kind of different skill sets. And what's the challenge of putting together a game plan for JT and also making sure you're bringing Dwayne along when they kind of have a different skill set?
That's a very good question. That's it's good to have both. You know, I've had that before. We have different skill sets at quarterback, and they're somewhat different. I don't know if it's drastically different, but somewhat different. So we just have, you know, the good thing is we have it all. It's just getting it ready to, so when you script plays, okay, Dwayne, you're in, and go. And Joe Burrow's, he's about 90%, so he's been cleared to play. He's still not 100%, but he's involved that all. And he's probably in between the skill sets. Yes, a little bit, not drastically, but a little bit.
All right, Urban, you talked about the kickoff coverage. That's kind of been one of your babies in your career, and you focused on the kicker. Is it just that guy that's creating some issues for you, or do you have other problems?
Other problems, and they're out there. Actually, practice ended, and they stayed out to get Larks to work, our kickoff team, because there was a loss of contain on a perfect kick on the one, and they brought it out 40 yards. It's the first time that's ever happened. Beat us to the field. That's never happened before. So, no, it's not just kicker issues.
That's a spot that kicking game in general is where you earn your keep, make a move. Is that where you're giving other guys?
Yep. You'll see some new guys with opportunities.
From the left, Doug. Urban, I think everybody saw JT's leadership potential early on here. I remember on signing day, people talking about what kind of person JT Barrett was. Can you see that in a young guy? What do you see? Are you on the lookout for that? I mean, I know you end up with a lot of great leaders here, but are you on the lookout for young
sure.
guys? And yeah. What do you look for? How do you see it?
Well, you first have a reputation when you recruit him in high school. You know, so they move to the front of the list if you hear that great word that he's a leader and that he has positive impact on those around him and lifts the, you know, just as a guy that provides energy for your program. There's nothing worse than a player that takes energy. There's nothing. I don't want him in here. And you come in and you take energy from the team and from us, then, and that's from bad attitude, lazy, you know, just you really don't like it. You know, that those people got to move on. They just don't survive here. And so we look for it. And then once we get a hold of them and they come here and you can start to see it, you know, Baron Browning's a guy that I can see has that potential. I can see Jordan Fuller has that potential. So, you know, we really look for that.
We always see it when you guys put out the hype videos and stuff, just the speeches that JT gives sometimes. guess what's your view on that? Is have you had guys like that who do that, or is he something different?
Yeah, I've had a couple. Obviously, that left-hander down in Florida was kind of like that. I had a kid named Brandon Spikes also down there that was kind of like that. I've had guys here, you know, Zach Moore turned out to be that. So, yeah, we've had a few really good ones. And Evan Spencer, Josh Perry, those kind of players.
Urban, in your career, you've always been very particular about the special teams. Why do those mean so much to you? Why do they continue to be so important to you?
Oh, it's a long story, but back in, not to waste your time, but back when I was at Notre Dame, Bob Davey came in and said, I'm going to make you special teams coordinator. I said, no, I don't want to do that. You know, I don't. But it was either that or get fired, so I said, okay, I'll do it. And I went on a journey and went to visit Frank Beamer, went to visit the Kansas City Chiefs, went to visit the New England Patriots, went to visit some of that was on my own penny because they didn't allow me to go do that on their penny. And I just learned how valuable it was. And I love it. I just think that's a difference maker. All the big wins we've ever had, ever, and since, you know, the special teams have had major impacts. I just name another play or plays where you have 40 yards, 50 yards to change field position every time you touch the ball. So that's why. I just love it.
And in some places, special teams is thought of almost like a chore. But even going back to your BG days, you've always been putting your best players in special teams. Is that one of your core philosophies?
Yeah, you think, and we just had this meeting with our team yesterday. I listed all the players from Zeke Elliott to Mike Thomas to, you know, Mike Thomas started as a center on kickoff return. That's how Zeke Elliott was our sixth on kickoff. Had a great play against Purdue 1 year. You know, knocked the guy out of bounds like a missile. You know, that's why I knew we had a good player. And there's certain players not allowed to play until you come on it. And we're at that point where he must have been snooping in our meeting the other day because that's exactly what we talked about.
Does the punt team still be first in the
field? Yes.
Second or right one? Remember, you said on Monday that you were sort of nervous about JK because you didn't get to see him as a senior. Do you remember your thoughts of his junior film?
Yeah, elite. Just didn't know the quality of football because it's a small school, and later found out it's great football and great coaching. And yeah, and then you just don't get to see him play your senior, so we're a little bit worried.
And then he's what you see on film. Would you agree?
Absolutely. And then a little bit more because you don't see on film what kind of person he is. I mean, he's a 3++ student. First one here. He's, remember the guy I told you about sapping the energy? He provides energy every time you see him.
Speaking of J.K., what in your mind would be an ideal way to, I don't know if it's split carries, but to use him and Mike Weber?
I'd like to eventually go two back. I'd like to, you know, I've done that before where you have those two, you know, because they're good complements to each other. And Antonio's getting better, too.
Are you a ride the hot hand kind of guy, though, Urban? I mean, how do you know when a back has a hot hand, I guess?
I don't know. I think during the course of a game, you know, I don't know how many times we've had that quality of players sit down next to each other. If they're both 100 miles an hour, if they're both refreshed, ready to go, that's I don't know if I've ever had that like that.
Another quick thing. UNLV, y'all are playing them this week. what stands out about them defensively?
Defensively, they're struggling a little bit. You know, they're big guys inside are what stands out. Offensively is the biggest concern right now. They're really good. They're fifth or sixth in the country in offense. But defense, they have two guys that, you know, have potential to be NFL guys inside, big 310-pound guys that you just have to control the line of scrimmage.
And final question, second for Reagan. How quickly did J.K. Relieve you of those worries about how he'd be after this season?
Pretty quick. Even off-season, you got here in January, in off-season conditioning, you start seeing it, then spring ball was. So there's no problem. We got one here.
You've never had two guys play like that right next to each other. Have you had to think differently or get creative with how to make the most out of both of them?
Not yet, because Mike hasn't been released to go play like he needs to go play. And so as soon as that happens, we've already been having a conversation about it.
Started thinking in that
way. Yeah. Like those checkers. Yeah.
Folks, thank you.
Thank you.